VTV6 live coverage of high school boys soccer kicks off right now. This broadcast is brought to you by L&L Motor, Strata Networks, Ashley Regional Medical Center, Pilot Logistics, and Moon Lake Electric. VTV6, your life in HD.
Good afternoon. Welcome to VTV, Channel 6 production of Uintah Basin High School Sports Action. We're here on the B&D RV pregame show. I'm Mark Mason. With me is Jared McCackney, and today we have a great matchup between the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons and the Uintah Utes. And Jared, these teams have played before this year. What was the result?
You know, they ended up playing a pretty tough game there in Spanish Fork. It went right down to the wire and ended up beating them at the end, but that was all.
Yeah, so and the Utes, they're good at these. When the close ones, they had an interesting game against Payson Friday where they went to Payson. Looked like they have control of the game, up 2-0. Red card for a hand in the box, knocking a ball out of the goal. Now playing down one man for the rest of the game, and they squeak out a win there 3-2 on a team that they had blanked 8-0 earlier in the season. So nothing's given. They got to play the games, and right now momentum building for the playoffs. I think the Utes are locked in on the 3 seed right now.
Yes,
in their region.
Yes, they are. They all they need to do is play these next 2 games, and I believe they're going to play Cyprus next week on the 18th.
So yeah, Cyprus is locked in at this in Region 6 as the 2nd seed. So the 2nd seed from Region 6 will play our region 3 seed, which is the Utes. So, and they've seen some of that region earlier in preseason action. So, interesting building toward the playoffs right now for the Utes. Want to remind everyone that today's pregame coverage is brought to you by B&D RV. B&D RV supplies the Uintah Basin with the best in RV sales, RV rental, and RV service. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, B&D will assist you in your purchases. Stop in at 1570 West Highway 40 in Vernal to check out our on-the-lot inventory. Well, Jared, here we are, a full capacity crowd there in the stands. And let's get right to the...
Thank you, Spencers, for your support.
Right. They had to fight for their seat there. That's their spot. They are third row, far north side. That's just their spot. So let's look at the keys of the game. We had... talked to the Spanish Fork head coach, Coach Shane Farron, and Jared, he had some keys to the game. We want to go over those.
You bet. Obviously, possession in the midfield, and I think that's going to be a point or a key that every team is going to want to try and accomplish is maintain possession in that midfield. He says, I'm going to focus and create attacks up front, try to this game. And then last point, he mentioned solid communication in the defense. And, you know, communication – and you live and die by that communication. So I think he's got some good key points there.
Right. So then we talked to Uintah head coach John Nurden, and he had some pretty bland keys to the game, or at least what he gave us. He said, okay, we want to play like a team. We want to stay positive. We want to take advantage of what the other team gives us. But, you know, like I say, those are somewhat bland as far as what the what he said, but off the thing, he said our goal is to attack. So he had a fancy word for if they had a turnover within 6 seconds, they want the ball back. So they're going to press attack everything, every turnover. They're going to press for really hard for 6 seconds, try to win possession back. And he really wants to go in strong here and not get into a close game that, you know, anyone could win or equalize right at the end. So that's keys of the game here on the B&D RV pregame show. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back for the starting lineups here at on VTV Channel 6.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
If getting in the woods is your thing, or catching that bull or buck, you'll need something to get you there. And get you there comfortably.
Come in to B&D RV. Our staff has all the right knowledge and can find what best suits you. We also have the parts and service that can get you back in the woods. B&D RV. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, we'll assist you with your purchase.
Ashley Regional Medical Center announces its first trauma designation, Level 4 Trauma. The physicians and staff at Ashley Regional have been working for over a year to complete this designation, which included forming a trauma team that can be called in for any designated trauma event in the emergency department. Several performance improvement projects were also launched and tracked in an effort to improve the trauma services at Ashley Regional. Ashley Regional is proud of this first step into the trauma field and will continue the work to provide great trauma care in the basin.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services, including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high-quality service to their customers now and in the future.
Slide coming out of it, or a roller coaster, and a zoo in the backyard, and a rocket on the roof.
No matter what you're looking for in a home, Mountain America has the mortgage loan to fit. First-time home buyers may even qualify for 100% financing with approved credit.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know, people who care.
Regional Medical Center announces its first trauma designation, Level 4 Trauma. The physicians and staff at Ashley Regional have been working for over a year to complete this designation, which included forming a trauma team that can be called in for any designated trauma event in the emergency department. Several performance improvement projects were also launched and tracked in an effort to improve the trauma services at Ashley Regional. Ashley Regional is proud of this first step into the trauma field and will continue the work to provide great trauma care in the basin.
If getting in the woods is your thing, or catching that bull or buck, you'll need something to get you there, and get you there comfortably.
Come in to B&D RV. Our staff has all the right knowledge and can find what best suits you. We also have the parts and service that can get you back in the woods. B&D RV. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, we'll assist you with your purchase.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high quality service to their customers now and in the future.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know, people who care.
My house will be really cool. It'll have a lot of rooms, like 100, or maybe 10. It will have a giant water park slide coming out of it, or a roller coaster, and a zoo in the backyard, and a rocket on the roof.
No matter what you're looking for in a home, Mountain America has the mortgage loan to fit. First-time home buyers may even qualify for 100% financing with approved credit.
If getting in the woods is your thing, or catching that bull or buck, you'll need something to get you there, and get you there comfortably.
Come in to B&D RV. Our staff has all the right knowledge and can find what best suits you. We also have the parts and service that can get you back in the woods. B&D RV. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, we'll assist you with your purchase.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6 here at Uintah High School, where the Uintah Utes host the Spanish Fork Dons. And we've just had the national anthem, and now presenting the starting lineups for the Spanish Fork Dons. We're going to get right to it. In the box is going to be Nathan Wengreen. He's a double zero. Then you'll see number three, Sean Soto, and Sean's a junior, plays in the midfield. Number 21, senior defense, Jacob Warnock. Number 33, junior in the defense, James Daw. Number 8, junior forward, Sam Mickelson. Number 23, Mike Jordan. And we've got number 13, senior forward, Daniel Stotzmeister. And number 7, senior defense, Josh Crook. Number 19, senior midfielder, Alex Rodriguez. And number 9, senior midfielder, Tanner Davies. And number 27, Joshua Gonzalez, junior midfielder. That is the starting lineup for the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons. And now for the home team, Uintah Utes, starting in the box, Gage Sepulveda. And number 2 defense, junior Trevin McCackney. We call him the Boomer. Number 3, Carter Seitz from the Cartel. He plays defense as well. Number 4, Rylan Nash. Number 5, Junior Flores, midfielder. We love to watch Junior play in that midfield. Number 7, London Wells, a senior, plays forward. And new starter this time, Canyon Larson. We mentioned the red card, but Canyon's going to step in. And, Jared, we remember him scoring in the last game. Beautiful volley. Canyon Larson, number 10. Number 11, Jaden Spencer. Spencer with the long runs. He gets that done. Number 12, Caden Nurden. Plays in the midfield. Number 14, Alex McGlory. Senior midfielder. And then number 22, Cameron Oakes, junior, plays in the midfield. That's the starting lineups here. We're at Coach Belcher Stadium, home of the Uintah Utes, and just seconds away from kickoff. Last game of the VTV Channel 6 season here for the soccer. And this will also be featured on the Sports Spin Game of the Week, so look for that. Next week airs Thursday, 6:30 p.m. on VTV Channel 6. Also want to remind everyone, right after the game, head over to the VTV 6 Facebook page for a live post-game show with Coach Nurden. And remember to subscribe to our Facebook live streams on VTV Channel 6. So teams going to have their last huddles. Jared, what your last thoughts before we go to the kickoff?
Well, I go back to the points that both coaches, have obviously tried to push to their teams. That's what the boys are talking about out there, is they're getting pumped up mentally, trying to focus and prepare themselves to go and do what the coaches have been talking about in their practices the last, few days. So it's going to be a game, obviously, of who can possess the ball in the midfield. And obviously, the shooting style and the defensive attack is a bonus as well. But, boy, that possession game is important.
Possession is key, and value those possessions, especially in games where the difference is one goal, as was their previous meeting. And it takes one possession to get that goal, so you have to value every single one of them. So here comes the attack pressing right away. Rodriguez plays back to the defense. Defense is going to look for possession. There's a turnover immediately. Oaks. Oaks centers it to
Canyon Larson.
Cotton Canyon, as they call him on the team, with that head of blonde hair. Nurden's all alone in the midfield. He sets up. There's a little give and go to Flores, and it's just off the mark. So turnover, counterattack from the Dons, waiting for the run. They hit that angle, but Trevin McCackney, solid on the left edge. He doesn't let a lot of those through balls get past him. Plays the angles real well. So back to Spencer. Spencer plays it up forward to McGlory. Possession to Wells. Excuse me, that's Nash in the back, isn't it? And there's one to Flores. Flores with a little flourish. Nurden wins the possession. Nurden taking on two defenders. Nurden has Wells out, Larson outside. He gains the baseline. Chips to Flores and cleared by the defense of the Dons.
Pretty good possession by Uintah right here. They've kind of pinged it around a little bit. Had a great run down the outside. So good start for Uintah.
We talked about the throw-ins last game, and I had a chance to talk to Coach Nurden, and he said it was a 50-50 ball. He doesn't care. But really, he only cared because we had something critical to say about his team on the air. So we'll see what happens here. Here's a lefty from McGlory, bounces off the defense. McCackney making a run from the defense. Flores chips it in the box, falls down, no call. Probably the right call, then turned over by the Dons, out of bounds. The turnover comes from number 19, Alex Rodriguez. So we have Alex Rodriguez from the Yankees and Michael Jordan from the Bulls out on the field. Wells, bad touch at the 8-yard line. Hit by Oaks right off the defense.
I noticed that Alex McGlory is playing an outside mid right now, almost as if Flores and Caden Nurden are playing in that center field position. So a little bit of a, I think that's a changeup. I'm not. I thought I had Alex in the middle as a midfielder. So
the way they make their runs, I think that the Nurden plays the mid in the forward position, and Flores is a little bit more of a defensive minded. But they all play so much offense that it mixes up quite a bit. Just as you saw right there, Spencer had a big long run, and it actually left the Utes with three defenders back. But, you know, Coach Nurden's style is attack, attack, attack. Here's a center to Wells. Wells hits it. Again, another mistouch by Wells, but McCackney up to receive. McCackney centers to Flores. Looks like Rodriguez. No, not Rodriguez. That's number 33, I believe, James Daw that came up. Ball out of bounds. Throw in Oaks. What a throw. Boy, what a weapon. Nurden gets to the baseline. His touch is a little long. Goal kick for the Dons.
Good opportunity. You know, Cameron Oaks does have a great arm there. And if you're any closer, boy, treat that as a corner kick.
Yay.
Set play.
Centered in there. Paul played outside to number 21 for the Dons. Pressure, turnover. So it's just good pressure defense. Forces that turnover. McCackney up to throw it in. McCackney has Wells, Nurden, and Oaks in front of him. McCackney fights for that, gets it. Played forward to the Dons. Just a little mistouch, and the Sites just waited for that mistake to happen. He clears it, and there's a wow, what a through ball with his knee. That was Jaden Spencer. And then we got an offside. So Nurden probably was like me, not expecting to get a through ball from a clearance on the defensive side.
Both London and Caden were still recovering back after that last play down low and got caught offsides there coming back.
So a little bit of wind coming out of the north. That's at the Utes back right here. Not too much of a factor. The one shot the Utes have had so far was about a 25-yarder, and it was Oaks that shot it. He tried to bend that far post and just set it about a yard outside. Flores dancing. He gets shoved off the ball but stays strong. Davies checking him, and finally Flores gets it, hits it out of bounds. Davies is a midfielder senior for the Dons. Spring clearance event going on now at L&L Motor. Save up to $9,000 off MSRP on remaining 2015 Ford Super Duties and 2015 Ram Heavy Duties at L&L Motor. So there's a pass to no one in particular. Turnover, number 33, James Daw. Nurden receives it. Nurden outside to Wells. Wells, few touches so far today. Have been a little bit strong, but he'll recover from that. Played soccer for a lot of years. Knocked out of bounds by Jordan.
Now here you go, Cameron. You've got a good opportunity. And
yeah, watch the strength of Cameron Oaks. He can get it about a third of the way into the box.
If London Wells can just flick that back.
Can't get it over the head of the defense. Up to receive it, Rodriguez. Rodriguez puts a through ball. He's got on a run, but Jaden Spencer, too much speed. He easily beats Mickelson to the ball, turns it, gets it to Wells. Nash did a pretty good job of convincing the referee he got tripped, maybe a little incidental contact. Well done by Nash, I would say.
Absolutely. And, you know, a lot of times we've joked that we're too tough to fall or to what is that called?
Flop.
And I tell you, some of that is part of the game.
So there's a deep ball. Spencer hits it. Oh, wow, punched out. That keeper had the Peyton Manning happy feet dancing on his line, waiting for that ball to come, and he punches it out. Wow, what a strike from Spencer. And I think that was a 50-yard punt.
That was a 50-yard punt. That was a little bit of help from the wind, but on target, almost in.
Nurden from the corner. Nurden up, passed. Oh, it just goes over Cotton Canyon. Out of bounds. and goal kick for the Spanish Fork Dons. Strata Networks is always working to bring you better service in more places. You can now enjoy enhanced coverage in Strawberry River and Bluebell on the Basin's number one network, Strata Networks. There's a run through from Flores. And you see both Flores and Nurden playing that midfield position. And both of them like to run through there. Right now, Flores up at the front line. Canyon wins. Well, he battles against Jordan, knocked out of bounds, so he does win that battle.
You know, I've really liked Uintah and their through balls. It's just an easy touch from the guy that's just received the ball, the guys on the run that just made the pass, and that is fun soccer. They just blow by those defenders.
Waiting for the run. Canyon gets it through everybody, and then the keeper, boy, I don't think anyone expected him to throw it that far. And Wells was flat-footed, and Nurden didn't even make an attempt at it. So back here to Stadmeister. Stadmeister looks through. Stadmeister easily taken by Spencer. Played back to Seitz. Seitz up to Flores. Nurden in the middle. Nurden with the right foot. Nurden, he sends Wells, and it's too much. Going to roll out of bounds. That'll be a goal kick.
I'm noticing that Uintah is playing more in the middle of the field. You know, they've had a couple of runs where they've gone down the outside, but the last couple, down the middle of the field, some good give and goes.
And you can see a little bit of frustration building from the Dons. They're trying to do the short triangle passes and several times have knocked it out of bounds. And right there, a little bit of back and forth. Gonzalez hit it out of bounds and he was frustrated. And so here comes a ball. Flores can't get to it, but he's going to battle and win. McCackney plays it forward. Chipped. It's going to get to about where Seitz ran back to receive it. He heads it back in. Settled. Played to Stadmeister. Stadmeister against McCackney. McCackney and a double team from Spencer. And Nurden gets through with the nutmeg, and out of bounds it goes. Knocked out by Gonzalez, and he gives it a little extra touch so the defense can recover. Nurden gets through, tripped, nothing in the box. He's not going to get that one from Mortensen. McCackney gets it up. Wells has a chance. Oh, defended by the Dons. I wasn't sure who it was. That's the left back that came up and just got a foot in front of it right when he was going to strike.
I like these opportunities that these Uintah is taking right here. We haven't seen them trying to shoot outside very often. They try and give and go right down to the goal line. But what
a throw again, and maybe just a little too much. Bounces to the keeper. Jacob Atkinson playing goalkeeper. No, excuse me. It's Nathan Wengreen is the keeper. Ball got all the way up to the defensive third for the Utes, and they trying to work possession, turnover.
Alex McGlory is so fast.
There's a ball, gets through to Davies. Davies with the right foot. Puts a solid contact on it, and Sepulveda playing his line and also inside post had that easily defended. But the Dons with their first real threat of the game and now have a corner. And in to take the corner is Alex Rodriguez. Rodriguez with his right foot.
A couple of guys not marked on Spanish Fork side.
Two. And here's the strike from somebody not marked. And that's what happens. Unmarked on the 18, the far side. And with the one-time volley, he hits it home. I didn't see a number. We'll see it on the replay. Try to catch his number as we look here. And it's the... number three is what it appears. Here it is, Soto. And if you go back to that corner, four were in the back corner. Two of them were marked. Soto was one of the unmarked offensive players. Nails it home on the one-time volley. Well done by the Dons. And the Utes just cannot let, on a corner, somebody roam free. Nurden unchecked. Nurden with his right foot. Chips it high over the post. So down one, it's reminiscent of the first Don scored first in their first meeting. And it's hard to put things back together mentally. You have to get some momentum built up. And, of course, once you've scored, you have so much confidence that the Dons will have a little temporary boost from that. Nash with the throwdown, and he just took Stadtmeister out of the air and put him on the ground. Nash is a physical player, Jared.
Nash is a hockey player, and you use your body a lot in hockey, so maybe he thought it was a few months ago and wanted to be physical there. So
just a in-the-air battle, little push, pretty easy call for the center referee. Nurdin plays it back to Spencer. Canyon making the run, can't get to it. McGlory does. London Wells has it. London waiting for the run, sends it outside to Canyon a little too much. He's been a little strong all day.
It's so frustrating as a coach because, you know, I would say right now that Uintah has pretty dominated the possession so far in this game. You know, the first 13 minutes, we've been on the defensive side of Spanish Fork, and to have them go down the two or three times that they have and be able to make that score is so frustrating because you know you've possessed it more and better than the Spanish Fork Dons.
Yeah, there was a nifty little move by Canyon Larson on the sideline. Just kind of a heel kick. So there's the possession. McGlory to Nurdin. Nurdin has it. Nurdin thinking shot, but centers it instead. Back to McGlory. Can't get a shot off. Cleared by the Dons. Sent forward. Oh, and there's trouble. There's a through ball. The runner's Jordan. Jordan slows it down. Caught up by Spencer. Seitz gets it cleared out. The defense is a little bit disorganized, it appears, and then the foul from the push. I believe it was number 23, Jordan, with the push.
You know, Spanish Fork, there was a point there where it was 3-on-1. Three offensive players for Spanish Fork against one from Uintah. They were bringing all three forwards were right there ready to attack.
Settled by the Dons. Through ball. No offsides. And they do call offsides. Wow. It was it looked offsides, and that line route judge looked
he started going with them a little bit, and then he decided to come back to where the ball was first kicked, and they were off, and then eventually called the offside. Luckily for Uintah, because that was a two on the goalie.
Yeah, 2-on-none, and Sepulveda back there to do all the work by himself. What a run by Spencer at the baseline! Staves it, but unable to get it, and he's upset. But wow. That wasn't Spencer. Excuse me. That's Alex McGlory that made that run.
I don't know if that was scheduled or not, but it sure looked like it was a play almost with him just going hard and Trevin trying to get the ball over all the defenders. Almost was perfect.
Ashley Regional Medical Center is the home of the Basin's best orthopedic care. If you have broken bones, sprains, or strains, or if you have knee or hip pain, call our orthopedic specialists.
Looks like Max McGlory in for Canyon Larson, freshman Max McGlory. He's seen the back of the net several times as a freshman on the varsity level.
Yeah, he and his brother play really well together, have assisted in on both sides working that ball. So good to see the freshman on the field. Also nice to see Canyon get a start. You know, a senior puts in the time. Good to see, and he contributed well in this first half. Boomer with the left foot. Up to Wells. Wells can't track it down before it trickles out of bounds. Boy, I thought he had a little curl on that, and then it went left.
Didn't have the right spin.
Apparently not. Flores up to Nurdin.
Nice.
In midfield, McGlory. Wells fights for it. Can't beat Jordan. Settled by Spencer. Switch of the field a little too much. How much of this is the wind?
You know, the wind is blowing fairly good, but I don't know how much I could contribute to that.
A little bit of trouble on the – that was Soto. No, not Soto. Excuse me. It might have been Jordan, 23. Had a little trouble getting that ball settled so he could clear it. And Nurdin nearly made something happen by making that run defensively. Nash throws it in. Nurdin. Nurdin. They think about calling a foul, but don't because of possession. Jordan pokes it out. McGlory. Centers. Oh, Wells. This is time for one time. He's trying to settle that ball, but he has a guy on his hip. He just didn't have the right angle. Spencer battling with number 8 for the Dons. That's Sam Mickelson.
Wells coming back on that pass from McGlory. And there was Cameron Oakes going towards the ball. And so Cameron needed to speak up and say, let it go, because he was coming onto it and would have been a nice shot on goal away from all the defense.
Nice run here by number 13, Daniel Stottmeister.
Nash doing a good job there. He able to bounce it off the Spanish Fork dome before it goes out of bounds.
Flores up. Nice position by McGlory. Cleared by Jordan. Out of bounds. Yeah, and that's position soccer that you saw from Nash. He's waiting for that mistake, and as soon as he has the ball, he understands the position of the offensive player and bounces it off him. Nice switch field, Oakes! Oakes with his right foot on the ground. Not enough steam. Nice follow through by
Max McGlory.
Max McGlory, the freshman. And a nice show of class by McGlory. He did make contact with the keeper, Wengreen. But there was offside, so it's all moot anyway.
So fun to have that intensity from a freshman that is going after every single ball that is close to the goal.
Ball played forward, tracking it down. Stottmeister, he gets shouldered down. They're going to call a penalty in the box. No, I think they're going to call it right outside, but it's almost as dangerous. And I think on the attack... I didn't see which Ute player attacked, but maybe we can see that on the L&L Motor replay. Knockdown, and they're going to put it right on the 18-yard line, and it's McCackney. That's clean. That's shoulder-to-shoulder, and he won the ball fairly, and they call a penalty. This is a very dangerous area here. They're going to give him 10-yard mark off, and Seitz is still talking to the center referee, saying, hey, I don't know. At least they didn't give him a free penalty kick and having the Dons go up 2-0, although this is an opportunity. And look at the left side of the defense, Jared, already an unmarked Don. And I think McCackney recognizes that. Even though he plays left defender, he was walking over to make a check there. So from about 15 yards away from the box, 12 yards length with the box is where the line is established. And in to take it for the Dons. Rodriguez just misses far post.
That was a good shot by Rodriguez. You could tell that he's done that. He's practiced. He's practiced that a lot. Wasn't a big hard kick up over everything. It was just a nice, good, positioned shot.
Misses outside, so the Utes avoid the danger. McCackney to kick. Can't clear the defense. A little ping pong from the Dons. Flores tracks it down. Flores still fighting. No one has possession yet. Seitz puts it forward to Wells. Wells hit from behind. Tries to get it over to Oakes and can't. Just nobody has possession yet. McCackney, no quitting him. Here's the throw from the Dons. Gets through. Seitz turns it. Put forward by Stottmeister. McGlory to Nurdin. And then another turnover. Well played by the Dons. Seitz punts it forward. Wells going to fight against number 27 for the Dons. That's Gonzalez. Wells with the left foot. Wells scores! Wow!
Absolutely no give up by Wells right there.
Huh. Let's just look at that on the L&L Motor replay. Wells battled, and look at this. You think several times, and he puts it to his left foot, and one times it goes far post and gets the keeper on the ground, and that is one of the most difficult shots for a keeper to block, is the ones that are burning across the ground.
Side net, that was great. That was right to the side net. Well done, London.
London Wells, boy, he just battled and battled against Gonzalez, and finally wins, and it's the little touch. And we'd been maybe a hair critical of his touches earlier, and that's all evaporated with that beautiful play. It was a perfect touch under duress to himself. Boy, did you see Nash just get the nutmeg? That has a there is no call. It looked like they were going to call it a foul on Flores, and everyone stood up straight, and then the Utes realized there was no whistle. Sights up to Oaks. Oaks, no pressure. Oaks. Oaks has Nurdin ahead of him. Plays it to Nurdin, but it's behind him. Back to the defensive line. Switch field by McCackney. Can't get through. Wells was there. Spencer out to Flores. Flores at the line. Has McGlory. Nice run from Spencer. Spencer trying to center. Can't get it done. Blocked by Jordan. Flores chips it to the middle. Wells again! Wells working on a double. Wow, the one time in the air from London Wells on a beautiful volley. I think it was Jaden Spencer that sent him that ball. Unbelievable play by the Utes. The Utes now lead the Dons 2-1 here in about the, what is this? We've got to do our clock differently. Anyway, look at the one time in the air by London Wells. Beats the keeper, hits the far corner, and London Wells is having a great game.
You know, they touched the ball so many times on that outside that no one was guarding London. He was all by himself in the middle, right in front of the goalie.
Flores wins possession to Nurdin. Nurdin up. Chipped in the air by Jordan. McCackney touches it down, and oh, just a hair too long. Trying to settle that ball. It had a wicked backspin on it. You know, it hits his toe and just kind of rolled out. Played forward to Lopez. Lopez looking for help. Lopez tries to get inside Flores. Can't get it done. Turnover to Nurdin. Nurdin looked to switch the field. He plays it up to McGlory. McGlory has Oaks. What a pass by the freshman. Oaks with the speed. Oaks left-footed. Boy, he had time for a touch.
He did, and I think he was he saw London. London had them beat, and I think he was thinking cross, but so difficult to make that cross when you're on a hard sprint.
Settled by Spencer, back to Seitz. Seitz turns it, hits it up, headed up in the air by Warnock. There's a through ball. I think he's on sides. It's Stodmeister with the right foot! Sepulveda can't get to it. Wow. Equalizer from the Dons. Just beat the defense. McCackney digging in, trying to get there. Can't get it. The one touch by Stodmeister after the through ball. He just lined it up, and he went to the far corner and beat Sepulveda with our own medicine. That low burner, hard to get to as a keeper.
Who'd have thought 25 minutes in we'd already have 4 goals scored in this game?
Wow. Utes with the kickoff. McGlory up. McGlory to McGlory. McGlory with Max with the throw in.
Cameron Mansfield in the game for Cameron Oaks. Cameron for Cameron.
The Utes earn a corner kick there. Owned by the people they serve, Moon Lake is a cooperative, not privately owned, providing power to the area since 1938. Find and like them on Facebook. So the Utes have a couple of set plays out of the corner. And I believe they've got Nurdin up there with McGlory. And with the wind at his back, or wind pushing that ball into the net, that's time to try to serve that up into that. Nope, they give it to Nurdin. Nurdin, boy, he's so good at faking with his body. Here's the shot. Oh, he put it in. Did it go in and went over?
I think it hit the top of the football goalpost and went behind the net, which looked exactly like it was in the net.
I think McGlory shot that ball, and you're right, hit the goalpost and straight down. I thought he hit top bar and had scored, and then I saw his hands go to his head like he was disappointed. Oh, yeah, that's the one he'll want back. That touch went high. Dons with the goal kick. Oaks settles it. Oaks has very little. Well, no, here comes the pressure. That came quickly. Flores gets the turnover. Flores working. Flores shoots off the defense. Lopez turns it over at his 18 and then shoves Flores down. It was pretty easy.
Yeah, that was a good call. That was easy to see.
And Flores milking the slow get up, wants to make sure how painful that was. You should milk it after if you don't get the call. If you get the call, spring up. Yeah, there's the push down. Although landing on your tailbone's never fun. Doesn't matter what age you are. Pilot Thomas is proud to sponsor VTV's coverage of local high school sports. Spencer, 20 yards out. Spencer! And he earned a corner.
I would not want to be in the line when Jaden Spencer got a free kick, because he has a bullet for a leg.
Wow, that ball was hit on a line. And you're right. Whoever took that one is going to have a hexagon tattoo on his back. Nerden with the corner. Chips it up with his right foot. Beautiful deep ball. McGlory there to receive it. McGlory settles, but then turnover. Well done by Jordan. Plays it out of bounds.
Good pressure by Flores in keeping that ball on this end of the field.
Nash for the throw goes to McGlory. McGlory, nice turn. So hard to do with the defender on your hip like that. Over to Nerden. Back to Max. Max plays it up. Back to Nerden again. Nerden shifts. Gets that ball turned over. Good defense by Lopez. Just cut off his angle. McCackney slide. Knocks him down. I believe he got Davies. They're going to give him a kick for that one. Just a hair late on that slide. That ball got through and then his carry through knocked Davies down. Jordan's got a big leg. Number 23 right about midfield. He can make it to the box here, but he is kicking into the wind. His kicks from the goal line have got past midfield, and he should be able to hit that up into the 18 area. Low driver cleared by Flores. McGlory up. And then turnover by the Dons. Boy, no pressure turnover. Those unforced errors are big.
Yeah, I'm not sure if they're just always going forward and they haven't recognized the ability to go sideways or back to maintain that possession. It feels like everything's got to get down the field.
And so far, their long balls have worked to an advantage of a tie right now. 2-2 here at Coach Belcher Stadium, home of the Utes. The Dons playing the Utes to a draw right now. Boy, there's just another one. Why turn the ball over? Somebody on his defense has to say, hey, you got time to turn this ball.
Alex McGlory going hard there, but still 10, 15 yards away as he just pops that out of bounds.
Yeah, turn towards the line, and if there is pressure, then kick it out. But don't just give it away for free. McGlory with a throw in. Waiting for Mansfield. Mansfield the closest, then has Flores deep. Flores receives back to McGlory. McGlory spins, hits Nerden. Nerden has McCackney coming up, doesn't see him. Boy, that would have been a nice switch of the field with McCackney coming up from the left side. He's a defender that has a propensity to score and has done it earlier in the season from that back left position. So ball on the ground to Wells. Wells sends it over to Oaks. Not hard enough, cleared by the Dons. Throw in.
You know, I like Uintah. It seems like they're trying to do so many through balls to those forwards. And those forwards need to understand that instead of running straight down the field, they've got to make an angled run. Will provide so many more opportunities.
Lopez hits Stadmeister. Stadmeister checked by McCackney. Stadmeister with his right foot blocked by McCackney. Trevin is a solid defender. Very, very rarely do you see his footwork where he gets beat on those runs. And well done. Knocks that ball out of bounds. Corner for the Dons. Let's
see if we mark up a little better for Uintah right now. Nope.
Still runners deep, and it gets through. So knocked out of bounds with the head of the Don. McCagney for the corner kick, or for the goal kick, excuse me. McCagney switches that field, bounces over the defense to track it down as Crook. Crook sends it.
Cameron Mansfield has a good arm too. I've seen him throw that ball a long ways.
He plays for possession there. They turn it. Well, no, it goes to Sites. Sites out to Oaks. Oaks checked by Warnock. Oaks stolen from Warnock. Warnock, a little 1-2 game. Now it's Lopez. Lopez makes the turnover against Nurden. Nurden coming through. Nurden still trying to get through. Finally cleared out. Possession goes out. It's Stodmeister. Stodmeister checked by McCackney, who quickly retreats. So Stodmeister loses that one out of bounds. Oh, up to Nurden. Knows it offsides on the. Oh, shoot. And Nurden just stepped on the ball and rolled himself down. Stodmeister plays it backwards to his midfielder. That's Lopez. Lopez looking forward, checked by McGlory. Nice switch of the field, but McGlory, oh, you know, that's a good defensive run, and then he just can't get the possession once he gets it. Nash tracks it back, turns it, plays it up, and it's still in bounds. No Ute close. And just a mistouch by the Dons. I believe that was Josh Crook. Nobody on him, and knocked it out of bounds. The Ute's a happy recipient of that turnover, Jared. And
Cameron Oaks throws a drill.
Receiveth, the good Utes giveth back. So
he threw that ball so hard, London just didn't have a soft enough touch.
Flores plays a ball through. Wengreen easily wins that one. Too deep for McGlory, even as fast as that kid is. Played back. McGlory coming up, boy. You play a ball back, you forget a forward's back there. That's dangerous. Wengreen clears. Up to receive it. Spencer. Spencer to Crook. Crook out of bounds. With a low-rate auto loan from Mountain America Credit Union, you can get the perfect loan for your new or used vehicle. Talk to us about auto loans as low as 2.99% APR at Mountain America Credit Union. About 5 minutes left here in the first half, Jared. Even Mansfield plays it up to Wells. Wells checked by Soto. Soto wins, then knocked out of bounds by Wells.
Trying to see the Spanish Fork player's number that's in the center of the field there, kind of as a stopper, number 27 or 27. Yes. He had his hands behind his back. As the ball was heading down into that corner, as if to say, I'm not gonna use my hands. I thought that was interesting that he did that.
Maybe some past experience with painfulness down there.
Well, he's a big guy. Look how broad he is. He's a good sized kid.
Nurden in a battle with Jordan, knocked out. You can hear Nurden from all the way across the field telling which players to make those runs. Centered by Nurden. Received by Flores. Flores trying to get it to Wells. Can't. McGlory has it settled. Flores trying to get to it. Mansfield. Mansfield has the ball. Getting it up to Nurden. Chipped out by Crook. Spencer hits it to Sites. Sites up to McCackney. McCackney position. Hits it out to Oaks. Interesting. They call it a foul. What do you think on that foul from Tanner Davies?
You know, that's such a judgment call because I guess you've got to be within a playing position of the ball. Apparently the referee felt like he was not allowing the Uintah player to get close enough to the ball, and so it was obstruction.
Another turnover from Josh Crook, paying on the left side of the Don defense. Boy, McCackney hit a nice ball from that 45-yard line. and he curled it at the post. And the keeper, Wengreen, kind of gave up, thought it was out, and it almost curled in. I mean, right at the last minute. Here's a run through by McGlory. Boy.
Great pass by Caden Nurden there. Almost a beautiful touch by McGlory to one-touch that in.
Nurden up to Wells. Put high in the air by Soto. Nurden again. Has Mansfield. Mansfield settles. Has help behind him. Does elect to go to Nash. Nash chips it in the middle. Offsides. Well, they call the offsides and point it vigorously, but Wells made no attempt on the ball, so it is correct that it should be a goal kick. It doesn't matter anyway. It's about a two-yard difference on the position of the ball, but Soto can't settle. Mansfield does. Soto again. Flores trying to hop through the feet of the defenders. Oof. That was a pretty clear trip and no call, huh? Wells trying to heel kick it. Can't. Up to get it. It's Jaden Spencer. Right foot. I thought he had shot in his mind.
I think he had shot in his mind as well. And, and you know, nobody was up there, so might as well take a shot. I didn't see who was – might have been open short, but.
Interesting goal kick there. What did you think of that?
Yeah, I don't know why you'd go right back to the guy kicking the goal kick because you're at the same distance. Maybe the roll makes you kick it farther coming back.
Certainly didn't help as he got underneath it and spun it up in the air. So Warnock earns 5 yards of field position by sliding up the line, finally throws it in. Stoudemeister, the senior forward. No, they hand it to Davies. Davies goes short, turned by Rodriguez. Cleared by McCackney. Wells in a battle against Crook. Up to get it. It's Mansfield. Mansfield playing that left outside line. Boy, he just couldn't get a foot on it. Not the right one anyway.
Yeah, just a little bit tough. It looked like that ball was spinning after it came from London and was just trying to touch it to get it. Keep it back in.
Crook tries to clear it. Oh, boy. Lost opportunity, but he tracks it down. Is McGlory out to Mansfield. Mansfield back to McGlory. McGlory trying to get through. Can't. Daw with a nice defense play, but they call a penalty against Mansfield.
Yeah, Mansfield's going a little bit out of control there, but I like the aggressiveness. I like how hard he was working right there.
Soto with the kick. No, excuse me. I think that's Jordan. That ball gets through. It's a foot race. Stoudemeister, but cleared by McCackney. Wow, McCackney's good. Got that turn under duress. Stoudemeister has scored earlier on one of those runs. This play is back to the midfielder. And then settled by Flores. Flores has Oakes on the run. Opts not to go that way direction. Goes to McGlory. McGlory unchecked at this point. Crook tracking him down. Plays it back to Nurden. Nurden shoots and scores! What a strike! What a strike by Nurden! Full speed and hits, goes high over Warnock's head, or Wingreen's head, and scores. Boy, what a run by the whole team.
You know, they didn't quite have as many numbers as them, but as you can see there, Alex going down the outside notices everybody else is covered and everybody is down. Caden being smart, coming down there just a little bit behind in a second level attack and all by himself.
Wow.
Great shot and great pass by two awesome players.
Nurden has runners with him. Nurden's going to stretch out the defense, looks to center it. No pressure. Hits Oakes. Oakes, we are in bonus time right here in the first half too, Jared. So it's interesting that the Utes would go up 3-2. In the injury time of the first half, I believe. Do they do injury time in the first half? I don't even know.
Yes.
Okay, and so there's the signal for halftime. It'll go to their benches, and the Utes with an incredible run right to the end of the half, and Nurden puts up the Utes up 3-2 with an incredible strike. We'll be right back for the halftime highlights here on VTV6. Stick with us.
Regional Medical Center announces its first trauma designation, Level 4 Trauma. The physicians and staff at Ashley Regional have been working for over a year to complete this designation, which included forming a trauma team that can be called in for any designated trauma event in the emergency department. Several performance improvement projects were also launched and tracked in an effort to improve the trauma services at Ashley Regional. Ashley Regional is proud of this first step into the trauma field and will continue the work to provide great trauma care in the basin.
At Boone Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Boone Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high-quality service to their customers now and in the future.
Welcome back to VTV6. We're at halftime. We're going to get to some highlights of the first half action here on the L&L Motor replay. And let's just dive right into them because, Jared, it was an action-packed first half. And here's just that 42-yard strike from Spencer. And the keeper, you see him dancing just like Peyton Manning when he gets nervous. And there's the shot, a block, Davies, but Gage Sepulveda said, nope, not on my turf. Here's Soto on the one time, finds the back of the net. And then nice shot by Oaks, can't get it to go. And that, with the left foot, London Wells, I mean, that's just a battle, and he wins it. Chip up, Wells, one time. And Wells ran back to the center line faster than he did anything. And then you see here, Stadmeister, he had that run on the right edge, got it. But for the lead, Caden Nurden, recipient of a nice pass, and he one-timed that in the back of the net, and that was a dart. I mean, he put it right top of the post where the keeper couldn't get to it. Keeper made a little mistake coming off his line, Jared. If he'd stayed back a little farther, he might have been able to punch that out, but Nurden made him pay. Utes lead 3-2. What are your thoughts on the first half?
You know, as the game has progressed there and to see both teams getting strikes here on both sides. You know, I talked at the beginning of the game that it felt like Uintah had gained some possession and had more possession. I think, you know, Spanish Fork is, I think they probably still have it, but it's probably a 40-60 instead of the 30-70 that maybe it was. And so, you know, Spanish Fork has come through with some fast attacks where they're able to outrun the Uintah Utes and be ahead of them. But you can't deny how Uintah has just come with some amazing passes, some absolutely beautiful shots to be ahead 3-2.
Yeah, and evidenced on that last run in injury time in the first half. I mean, that's runs and passes. I think four Utes touched that ball on that run, you know, culminating with the shot from Caden Nurden. And that's what you're talking, beautiful passes, on time, on target, and, you know, and then just gorgeous shot to cap it off. And it's, to me, it feels like a game the Utes should be up by more than 3-2, but history shows that the Spanish Fork Dawn team is scrappy. They're going to stick with it. They're going to fight. They're going to just kind of try to keep it in there, trying to find that way to sneak into an equalizer right there at the end of the game. So we're here on VTV Channel 6 and here at the home of the Uintah Utes. And it's been a beautiful day for soccer, but coming out of the north looks like a storm. So we always said, you know, it's a time for soccer at Uintah High School when it starts raining. So maybe you're going to have some rain here in the second half, and the wind is certainly picking up. Could be a factor because it'll be at the Dons back in the second half.
Yes, Uintah has definitely got to be prepared for that. Now, again, the times that Spanish Fork Dons have scored were the through balls and just absolutely outrunning the Uintah Utes there. So the wind can be an advantage on that.
Yeah, and they'll play that, and they've shown that's their style. And Stadmeister, number 13, is a guy to watch for. He's scored one. Soto, he hit the other one for the Dons. That was on a corner kick, but they earned it on one of the deep runs on the counterattack. So things to watch out for in the second half here on VTV Channel 6. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back for the start of the second half.
My house will be really cool. It'll have a lot of rooms, like 100, or maybe 10. It will have a giant water park slide coming out of it, or a roller coaster, and a zoo in the backyard, and a rocket on the roof.
No matter what you're looking for in a home, Mountain America has the mortgage loan to fit. First-time homebuyers may even qualify for 100% financing with approved credit.
If getting in the woods is your thing, or catching that bull or buck, you'll need something to get you there. And get you there comfortably.
Come in to B&D RV. Our staff has all the right knowledge and can find what best suits you. We also have the parts and service that can get you back in the woods. B&D RV. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, we'll assist you with your purchase.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know. People who care.
Ashley Regional Medical Center announces its first trauma designation, Level 4 Trauma. The physicians and staff at Ashley Regional have been working for over a year to complete this designation, which included forming a trauma team that can be called in for any designated trauma event in the emergency department. Several performance improvement projects were also launched and tracked in an effort to improve the trauma services at Ashley Regional. Ashley Regional is proud of this first step into the trauma field and will continue the work to provide great trauma care in the basin.
This broadcast is brought to you by L&L Motor, Strata Networks, Ashley Regional Medical Center, Pilot Logistics, and Moon Lake Electric. VTV6, your life in HD.
Welcome back to VTV Channel 6. Mark Mason, Jared McCackney here at Uintah High School. The Utes lead the Spanish Fork Mighty Dons 3-2, and now the Utes have turned and the wind has picked up. Storm clouds on the horizon. The Dons with the wind at their back, and we are off. 40 more minutes of soccer here, and Utes have their place in seeding locked up and in the playoffs. Playing against a region foe, so nothing can really come for this other than pride. Nurdin settles. Nurdin gets past the initial line. Settles it to Wells. Wells with the... Oh, I thought he was going to hit that left foot. He hits it to Canyon. Canyon tripped. It's a penalty.
In the box.
Wow. And the Utes come out firing. Not even a minute gone, and they're going to be scoring here. And who gets to take it? Do they call it outside?
Nope, I think it's...
And we've had a switch at goalkeeper, and I think it's a freshman, Jacob Atkinson, in the box now. And, boy, Atkinson's probably saying, hey, coach, do me a favor and don't get a penalty within 30 seconds of the second half. And London Wells, and I saw London Wells in a shootout down in summer games in Cedar City, and he was so calm and collected, and he put it in. Here he is for his chance. Wells misses, cleared. The flag's up. What does that mean when the flag's up on a penalty kick?
It means that the goalie encroached the line before the ball was kicked. The goalie's got to stay in a perfect line and not go forward or anything until after the ball is kicked. And apparently the referee felt like he came forward. So London Wells gets a second up here.
So Atkinson comes up to the ball. Wells has an opportunity. If he scores this, it's a hat trick for Wells. He missed the first penalty kick. That flag came up immediately. I'm glad you know what you're talking about. Wells hits. Wells in. And Wells hit it straight where the keeper was. That's crafty.
Is that crafty? I don't know what that is. It is such a crapshoot anyway to try and decide which way they're going to go.
Here's the replay. Wells with the second chance. He hits it straight into the back of the net. Atkinson. He tried to guess. He went right, and it was the wrong guess. And, well, the Utes now lead 4-2. Canyon Larson earned that. He's the one that went for possession, and he might have scored if they hadn't tripped him.
Yes, he just got tangled up. The guy had kind of tripped him from behind, and Canyon didn't have a chance to do anything.
Yeah, and it's one of those double foot fall downs where your face hits first. You know it's a trip then. Chipped into the middle. Stadtmeister on the run. Stadtmeister against Gage. Sepulveda wins. He rolls it out to McCackney. McCackney's got a little bit of pressure from Mickelson. He plays it forward. Oaks trying to win. Oaks, aggressive fight there. Still possession. Dons. That's up to number 19, Rodriguez. To Jordan. Jordan loses it. McGlory has Larson, excuse me, on the run. He plays it up to Flores in the middle. Flores out to Nurdin. Boy, I love Nurdin's hips. He can lean somebody out of position, and he just stays centered and then explodes as soon as they do take that step. Flores from about 35 yards out. No, they're going to give that to Jaden Spencer. McCackney with some advice. Spencer chips it up. McGlory can't get past Jordan on the defense. Nash comes up, plays the ball forward, and then knocked out of bounds by the Dons. Ashley Stone is proud to support VTV's coverage of local high school soccer. Remodeled tile, cabinets, countertops, bathrooms, kitchens. And with talented employees, Ashley Stone is the contractor for you. Nurdin to Flores. Turnover. Here comes the counterattack. Ball played forward way too deep. Stadtmeister says, yeah, I'm going to pull up the brakes about 40 yards away from that one. Sepulveda has Jaden Spencer unchecked. He's going to boot it away. Flores, nice touch there. Flores wins again. It's outside. Oaks looking. He sends it outside. Nash, excuse me, that's London Wells. They both have beards. It's not fair.
It's not, and they are young to be able to do what they do with their beards. When they're 40, they're going to wish they didn't have all that to have to deal with every day. But it's cool when you're
high school. I'd say it's cool when you're in your 40s. Just let it grow, Jared.
Is that what it is?
Just let it grow. There's an old Disney song about that. Let it grow. Stoddmeister on the outside edge. Stoddmeister pushes it back with his right foot. Shoots. Trying to hit that back upper 90. And he sends it far wide. I'm glad Stoddmeister had that run. It interrupted that song. That could have been embarrassing if we continued that.
You'd have kept going, I know.
Let it grow. Let it grow. I don't need Dollar Shave anymore. Okay, so back to the soccer game. McCackney punts it up. Can't get past the defense. It's number 8 for the Dons. Mickelson does lose it there. Nerden up Oaks and sends it too far for Oaks. To Rodriguez, bounce off at Ute. Substitutions coming in. So, Anderson, I haven't called his name before. I'm not sure if this is his first entry into the game, number 29. But
how would you say that first name?
We're going to just call him Anderson.
Okay.
Yeah. Kiela. Turn, shot. Not much velocity on that one. Picked up by Sepulveda. The bone breaker, bouncing. Interesting conversation with Gage Sepulveda in the middle of the week. He said he's played football for 8 years. They're going to call a foul on Seitz. 30 yards out. This is a dangerous opportunity straight on. Anyway, Sepulveda said, I played football for 8 years, but this is the most fun he's had on organized sports, and he thinks it's because they have such team camaraderie.
I would agree with that. You know, they came to our house last night for their team dinner. And no one was alone. Everyone was together. You didn't have the little groupies that were off doing their own thing. And stayed there, played games, just did everything, and everybody was together. You didn't see anybody that was separated or off on their own. So great year for this team to hold that together.
And, you know, from the keeper, so many times they're the vocal leader on the field. They have to communicate so much. Wells with a nice run, forces it back. Atkinson, he clears. Wells is not satisfied with a hat trick. He's trying to get some more. That ball up to Stoddmeister, checked by Nash. Nash, man, Nash is just a brute. You're not going to get past him with fancy footwork. You got to go passing and speed. Oh, boy, Seitz. That's a good time to clear it. Good run. I didn't see which one of the Dons came up and put that pressure. And Gage Sepulveda, there's the time for the vocal leader to say, you got pressure, you can't do this.
Get it out, for sure.
So ball handled by Rodriguez. Rodriguez tries to center. Cleared by the Utes, up to get it. McGlory looks like he's going to punt long and then just takes a little step and then knocked out of bounds. Number 23, Jordan. Stolen by Soto. Soto coming back to the ball, has a little bit of help, but just decides he tries to switch the field. Works out. Well, no, it doesn't work out. Seitz, well done. Plays it outside to McCackney. McCackney has Oaks running deep. Oh, and here's danger here for the Utes. Coming back to get it, Mickelson. Mickelson, checked by Seitz. Seitz waiting for him to make a mistake. He centers it. Coming up, Rodriguez. Rodriguez puts it to himself with his right foot. Can't get a solid contact because of the defense from the cartel.
Great job by the defense there. It was 3-2 against 3, and they just positioned up and caught the guy coming back, the trailer, I guess you'd call him, and stopped the run. Good job, defense.
McGlory out to Mikey's made an entrance into the game. Michael Colton, I think this is his first action of the night, too. Is that right, or have I missed him?
No, I believe this is his first opportunity. Looks like Aori Riviera is coming in now for Cameron Oaks.
Yoda on the field, Yodi. I asked him if he liked Darth Vader or Yoda more. He said Yoda. There's a ball that gets over the head of the defense, but no shape to it. Just runs out of bounds. Hit by number 14 for the Dons. The Dons, if anyone's watching from Spanish Fork, we apologize for not having all the names right. There's no number 14, and number 23 is not actually named Jordan, but his name's not on the roster either, so having to make things up as we go along. McGlory, nice! McGlory has a tot, chance, hits it low, too far outside.
Grabs the shirt, throws it in your mouth, and says, oh, that was my opportunity.
Yeah, he's being tracked down by just a hulk of a defender. It's number 27, Gonzalez. And, London Wells has no idea that ball's coming. Hits him in the heels. If he'd had his back turned, he could have settled and shot.
If you've mentioned a pet peeve of yours a time or two as you've played soccer, as coaches have coached you, that is mine. You always face the ball, even when you're recovering like they were, because things like that. He could have settled it, chested it, and he'd have been just him and the goal.
Yeah.
But didn't, and so recovering him and Alex McGlory, not paying attention to what the ball was doing.
A little bit of maybe the competitive fire. Again, no seeding here. You're up 4-2. You know, it is a long season, you know. So you can forgive them for a little bit of a mental gaffe there. Ball back up to Flores. Flores turns back to track it down. He goes McGlory. McGlory to Yodi. Out of bounds. None. They're going to give it to the Dons. Even though I thought the last one to touch it was Jacob Warnock. He's in to throw it in. Looking for help. Oh, he's just trying to get a little advantage. And they call him backwards to where the ball went out of bounds. That was an interesting line judge call. He waited for the center referee to make the call. Then he whipped his
flag
up.
Then he threw his flag?
Yeah. Hesitantly bringing it up. Two-man game from the Dons. Switch field. Put into the air. There, it's cleared.
Number 29, Wilhelm, is in for Rylan Nash as a right defender. Coach Nurden playing some of these other players early in the second half.
Well, Drew's a junior. He has a transplant 2 years ago and had been a great contributor to the team. Wells on the outside has a chance to center. Trips it up. Oh, and he just puts it over Colton. Wow. Michael Colton coming in. And Wells, I thought maybe Wells going to hit that with his left foot. Ball rolled a little bit too fast, so he chips it. Mikey Colton maybe ran too shallow. Maybe needs to be closer to the
far post.
Yeah, the far post.
You know, that was a great pass by Caden. Dribbling hard. The Spanish Fork Dons on their heels and just makes a great pass over to London. That was a tough pass.
McGlory beats Crook. McGlory sends it outside. Oh, Yodi, they call him offsides, and he might have been.
It was very close because all the Spanish Fork Dons looked over at the ref like, is he going to or is he not? Because it was that close.
Just waiting for that ball. And that's just they just took a step towards the ball, and that's what caused the offsides. So chipped up, settled by Flores. Out to get it is Yodi, but Wells comes up from the forward position to receive that ball. Wells, Flores, back to Wells. Wells, nice push to the corner. Flores with the run. He gets it before it goes out of bounds, then knocked out of bounds by number 27, Gonzalez. So the storm that never was. There was a whole lot of bluster, and it broke apart before it got here, raining in the nearby Dry Fork Canyon, but not here. McGlory. Well, they call a penalty there, and you know, you see number 14 for the Dons hold out his hands and say, what? There's just contact, and actually, oh, there's the, so they're going backwards. Anyway, it was a possession thing. Maybe shouldn't have called that one. Flow of the game. Back to Sight. Sight switches to McCackney. Puts it in the air. Yodi puts it up forward to Nurden. Nurden plays it backwards and then loses it. There's a through ball. It's going to be a foot race. Is it too deep? Here comes Sepulveda. And he chose the right time to come off his line there. And he beat Stottmeister to the ball.
It's a little scary that he kicked it right, almost as if he was trying to hit Stottmeister.
Oh, no. They're calling a penalty, I believe. Everyone's confused, but it looks like a penalty on the ground from the center referee for the Utes. Okay, so that ball settled, put on the ground by Anderson. Anderson plays it in the middle. There's a chip over by Daw to Anderson. He cannot get to it. And then it's going to be, is that Mikey that?
Jaden Spencer.
Jaden Spencer, excuse me. Well, Spencer and Colton have those bright orange cleats. So that was a quick run. Max McGlory's coming back out. And back on the field is Cameron Oaks. Cackney, settled by Daw. Daw pushes it forward. Spencer turns with the left foot. Oh, they call it out of bounds. A little bit of discombobulation. The center referee needs to communicate and tighten that up a little bit. But there's a shot. But just the spin came off Jordan's foot weird. He hits it out of bounds.
Is that a word, discombobulated? Have you ever looked that up? I mean, I understand completely what it stands for, but that it because it's a great word. Like it just it's very descriptive, isn't it?
Yeah, I think, you know,
discombobulated.
We're gonna go to Google and well, it comes up on the search and it says discombobulated, and it is a verb. From North America, past tense, it means this attitude totally, it's to disconcert or confuse someone. So the answer to your question is yes, according to Google. Who came up with that word?
Google.
I think the reason that they have that fancy of a word for confusion is it's a confusing word. Out of bounds, Utes throw in. Online registration is now open at AYSO and will be open until the end of July 9th. Visit eayso.org to fill out your child's paperwork. Registration dates are May 7th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. and July 16th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. at UBATC in Roosevelt. Cost is $55 registration fee plus a $10 city fee. This cost includes a new jersey. Any questions, email Roosevelt, AYSO, at gmail.com. So, ball played forward by Crook. Turned by McCackney. In to receive it was the Utes. Can't get it done. Nurden finally does control it and then knocked away from him. Turned Number 19, Rodriguez, plays it forward. They're going to call off sides. There's been no play. They say play on. So Wilhelm back to get it.
Smart by Spanish Fork there to not stop the play.
Yeah, it turns into a throw-in. You know, Coach Durden says is a 50-50 ball instead of a free kick, which could have, you know, reversed the field in just one stroke of the foot. So, yeah, that is true. Crook plays it up the line. Stottmeister can't get the touch he wants on it. Spencer for the throw-in.
Look at the area on the far side. There is so much room there. One player on two-thirds of the field.
McGlory. Oh, gets his pocket picked by Gonzalez. He plays it forward. Here's a little man bun going on. Battle. Oh, Jaden Spencer says, I don't think so. But still, with possession, number 14. And he and Spencer are just... That is a major battle, and I don't know who would say would won that. The Utes have possession right now.
Yeah, Jaden Spencer did not give up there, and he's a tough kid. He's got some size. He should have played football. He's that kind of a size of a kid.
And his speed, the way he could get there. He was battling against Octavio Garcia with the – would you call it a stylish man bun, or is that like a mullet where in – 10 years, you're going to be embarrassed to say, yeah, I had the I had the man bun at one point. Is that because I had a mullet when I was a teenager, and I was pretty sure that it was the coolest thing that ever happened to me.
Yeah.
But now I'm embarrassed to say that.
My 12-year-old is attempting to grow a mullet right now, so he's enjoying the long.
He should come to Mullet Anonymous.
Actually, Connor, talking to Connor on Sunday and seeing him and him seeing Derek, it was quite funny. He made the comment that with hair like that, you can do whatever you want.
Crook throws it in. It's like a buttermilk chocolate bar. Gets it up to the near the baseline. A dangerous cross. From the Dons and snuffed out by the Utes. Coming back to get it is Flores to McCackney. McCackney, a nice possession to Yodi. Up to Flores on a nice run. Just too deep. Knocked out by the Dons. Does chocolate taste better with buttermilk?
Never had them together.
Buttermilk? Well, you know, you make chocolate with milk, so you get the really heavy, creamy buttermilk. That was... I'll have to do some research. Maybe we can go back to Google on that here in a minute. Flores, did you see what he did with his shoulders? He faked the defender out so bad, he had to go back and pick his shorts up. Some of the prettiest plays lead to nothing, but that was cool. He just flips his shoulders around. Gonzalez bites, takes two steps, and then they knock it out of bounds. But, wow, gee, that throw. Oh, Nurton tries to chop it across Crook, and I think Crook's butt stopped his leg. Nurton was just going after that ball. Ball played forward to Spencer. Spencer hits it out to McCackney, puts it out of bounds. Dons waiting for the throw-in. Dons not playing like a team down 2-0 with 16 minutes left in the game, that's for sure. Not a lot of urgency.
You know, the Dons have been doing a pretty good job, though. I've seen them putting together 5 or 6 different passes or opportunities with the ball and made the better passing instead of like it was in the first half.
On the ground, they pass it in to Jordan. Jordan's in the midfield. He just shoots from 40 yards out. Why not? Good things can happen if you shoot. And Sepulveda just dives on the ball and just makes sure. Sometimes you'd bend down to pick those balls up, and those are the ones that sneak past your gloves. He falls on it and makes sure. Yodi, nice touch to control it up to Wells. Wells puts it up to himself. Wells at about the 8-yard line. Wells pushes it back. Here comes McGlory. Left foot. It's in.
Signature play, Coach John Nurden. That is what he taught for 2 years now, is drive the baseline, back out.
And what a touch from McGlory. Comes in. Wells with the hat trick, now with the assist. Oh, my goodness. What beautiful soccer. Wells with a beautiful touch to himself. He's in a foot race with number 27, Gonzalez. He plays it to himself and then touches that ball to the baseline and then serves up just a perfect ball to the 18.
Now, handing it to Alex here, because when you have a slow roller coming to you like that, what do you want to do? I mean, what's going through your mind? I am going to kill this ball. And a lot of times when you feel that way, it goes up and out. But
here's a nice run by Mickelson, and Sepulveda snuffs it out, and Mickelson's down. And, wow, that is just one of those things. We call him the bone breaker for a reason. And Sepulveda waves to the sideline. He's a little bit shook up, and good to see Mickelson up. Sam Mickelson Jr., the forward. We'll see if we can catch that on the L&L motor replay. I'm not sure if we can. But that was a collision, number 8 versus Sepulveda. No replay it appears. So, here is the replay, and you'll see this. Ooh. Just hits him right on the ankles and chips him down on his head and shoulders. Good to see that young man up. Yodi touches it to himself. Yodi, wow. That's the difference between a senior and a freshman. I guess Yodi's a sophomore or is
junior.
He a junior? Okay, excuse me. Sorry, Yodi. You're built like a freshman. No offense. Nurden with control, hits outside. Yodi controls it. Yodi's got Wells and Nurden behind him, goes backwards. Good, centers in. And cleared forward by Gonzalez. Rodriguez, excuse me. And there's Stodmeister. Stodmeister tracked by Nash. Stodmeister trying to find an opening, cannot get past Nash. Stodmeister has help to Jordan. Jordan lets it run past to number 14 for the Dons. He plays back to Crook. Crook centers it in, stolen by Nurden. And here comes a counterattack for the Utes. 3-on-3, played forward to Nat. Oh, Wells, and it does get past, and it gets to Wells. Wells had the nice assist from this position earlier. Oaks with the right foot, chips. Oh, my goodness, perfect placement on the ball. Oaks hits the upper 90 and puts it in, and he almost looks embarrassed. Look at the look on his face. L&L Motor Replay. Watch the chip on the keeper, and he just hits that upper 90. And unfortunately for Atkinson, he didn't have a chance no matter how quickly he moved on that ball.
That was a good angle by the camera right there, because you could tell that it was about an inch away from the post. It was that close and up in that upper V. So nice shot, Cameron Oaks.
Well, 3-2 game at half. And the Utes are blank to the Dons in the second half, scoring 3. The Dons haven't really had a good, decent opportunity the whole second half, so the defensive adjustments from Coach Nurden have certainly worked. We thought the wind would play a little bit more of a factor, and it certainly has not. Seitz plays it out to McCackney. McCackney trying to find that angle for Yodi on the run. Flores in the middle against 2 Dons, and he wins. Nurden. Dancing, goes to Flores. Flores back to Nurden, up to Wells. Wells decides not to make that run, but Yodi goes after it. And Yodi against Gonzalez, and guess what?
Yeah.
It's about a 100-pound difference.
You know, that's the kind of defender you want in the back, though, is a big, strong, heavy-duty, not going to get around you defender.
Deep. Throw, keeper off his line. back. Jaden Spencer. He's trying to hit the low ball. Snuffed out. Crook on the counterattack. Crook can't get past McGlory. Chipped up. McGlory on a foot race. Can he get to it? No, the defense does. Knocked out of bounds by Jordan. McGlory back to Spencer. Spencer loses it. Played forward. It's number 12 for the Dons. Oh, this played out to Stodmeister. Is it too deep? It is. Had a bad spin towards the keeper and Sepulveda up to get it. He rolls it out to McCackney. McCackney up to Nurden. Oh, Nurden, just a turnover here. It could be a disaster. Number 17. 13. Stodmeister snuffed out by... Well done by Sepulveda.
Gage Sepulveda with a great save there. He was low, he was big, and luckily Stodmeister kicks it right at him instead of to the other far post, because that's where Gage Sepulveda was heading to the...
Here's the L&L motor replay. Here's the touch. Wow, what a strike by Stodmeister trying to get his second goal of the game. But Sepulveda says, not on my watch. Back out to Crook. Crook chips it in. On the run is number 12, Smith. Smith gets it, tracks it down, and Smith wins that battle. But a throw-in, boy, that's the worst spot to have a throw-in unless you got a guy like Cameron Oaks that can serve up the ball all the way to the middle. Knocked out by Yodi. So now a corner kick for the Dons. Now they have scored on the corner before, and then they like to put four guys about where that 10, the 10 is on the field.
33 unmarked, 14 unmarked.
And Soto scored right from where 33 is standing. McCackney at least acknowledges that he's unmarked, and now he's pointing out, and that's good organization by McCackney, the junior, excuse me. He's going to have one more year after this, is that correct?
Yes.
Crook plays it forward. Crook, he's got Smith. Smith cannot track it down before it goes out of bounds. Well, we have the sophomore game going on right now. We'll try to get an update for you on how that's going.
You got somebody over there with the game giving you updates?
Well, we're going to see if we can. We would think that I would get updates as you go along, but the answer to that question is I have not had any updates. So we'll find out. On the Strata Networks hotline here, see if they can get it. Nicely done by Stodmeister, and he almost gets it there. Had a really tough angle by the time he got there, and he knocked it out of bounds.
Good hustle, though, by Stodmeister. He seems like he's their go-to guy and is very athletic.
McCackney, goal kick. Hit in the air off the head of Anderson. Crook, no challenge, sends it into the middle. Outside, Stodmeister lets it roll past to 14. He hits. Ooh, he had a better shot there than I thought he would, you know. Sepulveda right on top of it, but boy, falling down, he got a good look at it. Flores has Oaks, one touch here. Oaks with the left foot sends it too far wide. That's about where he had to go.
Yeah, I don't know. He typically plays this right side or has been playing this right side. London Wells looks like he's coming in from the middle, so I'm not sure if there was a switch there and London didn't transition over far enough, but there was nobody at that backside post for that cross by... I was going to say Cushing, but that's not Cushing.
Yeah, it's Oaks. Cameron Oaks.
Cameron Oaks.
With that fuzzy head of hair. And he sends that ball, and you're going to call it a cross. I think he was trying to go far post with that shot. Yeah, and just didn't have enough angle. He sent it about the only spot he could get it.
Yes.
And Atkinson, the keeper for the Dons, defended it well, took away those angles. But like you say, how about a deep run on that far post, and you got a shot at it. That ball gets through to Sepulveda, and a little love tap from Stadtmeister. Nurdin settles it with his chest. There's that hesitation move that I love so much from Nurdin. It's so deceiving. Here's a through ball. Wells against the keeper. Atkinson with a beautiful save, and he couldn't have got there. I mean, that was just the perfect timing. Wells nearly had a chance for his fourth goal.
Good job by the Spanish Fork goalie. That took some guts coming out there that hard and having big old London Wales coming down your throat.
There's a ball through, and Jaden Spencer clearly offsides. He had at least three hash marks. What is that? 3 yards?
3 yards.
Yeah. Glad somebody can count. The booth helping us out with that math. Nice strike from number 14. Stadtmeister plays back. He's got Lopez. Lopez fighting and cleared by McGlory.
McGlory just picked his pocket like he was standing still.
Oh, you can see what Wells is thinking. I'm going to chip this over there. I'm going to give Oakes a chance to run underneath this ball and come have a one-on-one with the keeper. A lot of hands thrown out saying he didn't actually touch the ball. I think he whiffed. But
either way, we're up 6-2. So
yeah, maybe save your battles for later, right? It's like being married. Jaden Spencer, Stadtmeister puts it luckily into the middle, and then Crook up to receive it as a defender, chips it back in. Seitz doesn't get a good strike on it. Settled by Stadtmeister. Nurdin just says, nope. How about a nope sandwich right there?
With a little bit of buttermilk.
With some buttermilk. Flores. Oh, too much of a touch. And it's he and Jordan. Flores turns the ball on the defense, plays it outside and in for the first time. Well, Tarbell's been in for a little while. He came in for Yodi, if I remember right. But that's the first time I'm able to call his name. Don't forget to head over to VTV, the Facebook page for VTV6, right after the game for a live post-game show with Coach Nurdin. And remember to subscribe to our Facebook live streams. Also, this will be the game of the week for the Sports Spin. Get a full highlight package there Thursday night at 6:30 next week. This week. Thursday night, that's only 2 days away, 6:30 on VTV Channel 6. Cackney says, Lopez, get off the ball. And continues that battle. Tarbell back to help. Don's throw in. Very little substitution on the defense from Nurdin.
Yeah,
he has a lot of faith in those back four.
He does. We saw Andrew Wilhelm there for a short time. But with Andrew Bestenliner, with that red card and having to miss this game, Ryland hasn't missed a beat. I mean, Ryland's done a very good job playing that defensive right defender.
Jordan serves it up, gets it about the 8-yard line. Oh, nice run. And the run there was number 8, Sam Mickelson, who had the earlier collision. He pulled up a little short. I think he knew that ball was just carrying, though. Nurdin. Still dancing. Nurdin, and you see that Oakes was open, but he didn't pass to him, and it was a wise play by Nurdin. It was offsides. And so he didn't really have a lot of choice. Sepulveda comes and knocks that ball out of bounds. At least I thought Oakes was offsides.
I think you're right, because he was heading pretty fast, pretty early.
Stadtmeister back to the middle, chipped in by Crook. Tarbell. Late to the party, but he still gets a good seat in the house and wins that ball. But then back to Crook. Crook with the left foot can't get good clean contact.
I looked at the clock, and it said 1 minute. And he blew the whistle, and I thought, oh, he's calling the game. But just a substitution.
So, Jace Spencer. Is this the first time we've seen Jace?
It is.
Jace is a sophomore.
Freshman.
Is he a freshman? They've got him down as a 10th grade. Cleared out by Seitz. He's a freshman. There's a good crop coming up, a freshman right now. Back to Crook. Crook serves it in with his left foot. Played forward by Nurden. Nurden wins that ball. He sees that angle. Well done. And then Jordan misplays it, and he's going to give an opportunity on that far edge. And I don't think Cameron Oaks is in right now. No, he is. He's heading that direction, but I think Tarbell's going to throw it in.
Cameron Oaks way offside on that one, and luckily it went to London Wales' side because had it gone to Cameron, that was an easy call for a sideliner.
Oaks forces the corner. Looks like he'll kick it. And the sophomore freshman team tied 2-2. So their game's over, and apparently the fans are over in their car warming up. We're up here in the booth, and this sun's it's warming me up, my old bones. Here comes the counterattack from the Dons. Played forward, Stodmeister. Stodmeister pulled up. I'm not sure why. If he would have just gone for it, then he finally does win the ball right at the baseline. He's against Nash. Nash just settles and waits for that mistake. Jordan with the right foot. Jordan Owen Sepulveda gets right to the post. I think he knocks it out. It's a corner for the Dons. That was an interesting series for the Dons. Boy, that's a hard strike, and he puts it low and away.
Stoudemire with that stoppage or, you know, stutter step, something. He could have continued to run and really beat Ryland to the ball.
Yeah, it turns into an interesting threat. And number 23 hits a ball low at the far post. There's the whistle for the end of the game. Wow. And the Utes decide, hey, we had a 3-2 half. We're not going to have it that way in the second half. They dominate. We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back for the L&L Motor highlights of today's game after these messages.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services, including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high-quality service to their customers now and in the future.
At Boone Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Boone Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
My house will be really cool. It'll have a lot of rooms, like 100, or maybe 10. It will have a giant water park slide coming out of it, or a roller coaster, and a zoo in the backyard, and a rocket on the roof.
No matter what you're looking for in a home, Mountain America has the mortgage loan to fit. First-time home buyers may even qualify for 100% financing with approved credit.
Well, we're back here at VTV Channel 6, the end of the varsity game where the Uintah Utes hosted the Spanish Fork Dons, and they were not kind hosts. The Utes won 6-2, close first half, and the Utes poured it off in the second half. And, Jared, I think maybe it's your turn for the highlights. You want to take these away? We're going to go to the L&L Motor replay highlights, and here they go.
Okay, it looks like the Dons strike first here. On the outside, Cameron Oaks with a great shot for Uintah. London Wells working hard, getting a left foot shot right to the side net. Great job by London. London Wells again from a great side, or a great cross, sitting there hoping for the ball. Spanish Fork Dons with another hard net. And then, of course, Caden Nurden, third goal of the game. Penalty kick by London Wells goes in, the second one. And then Cameron Oaks with a within an inch of the line goes in. And then, of course, London Wells to Alex McGlory for the final goal. And unbelievable shot and pass by those two gentlemen.
Yep, and Sepulveda shutting the door and saying, no more for you guys. He was probably ticked off at himself for letting two go in. And I don't know which one of those is my favorite. So many good goals. You're going to have to check that the full highlight package out on VTV Channel 6 this Thursday night. We'll have it on the Sports Spin. I want to thank everyone for joining us here today. And head over to Facebook right now. We're going to go have a live post-game interview with Coach John Nurden. Thanks for tuning in, everybody.
This broadcast is brought to you by L&L Motor, Strata Networks, Ashley Regional Medical Center, Pilot Logistics, and Moon Lake Electric. VTV6, your life in HD.